Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. This is a really special video which all Muslims should focus on. This video will show majority of the Muslims some errors they have sadly fallen into. It can really help guide them to the true Islam if they ponder over it. It revolves around the views of a great Muslim scholar who is now 95 years of age. His name is Maulana Wahiduddin Khan. Let us first see what other Muslim scholars think of Maulana Wahiduddin Khan Sahib and how they have praised him.
Maulana Wahiduddin Khan Sahib ke mamle mein to main iske siwa kya arz kar sakta hu ki mere buzurgon mein se aur is waqt alam-e-islam mein wahi ek alim hai jinke bare mein kaha ja sakta hai ki wo alim hai, wo ek takhleeqi mufakkir hai. उन्होंने बड़ी खिदमत की है, उनका बड़ा ही गैर मामूली लिटरेचर है. उन्होंने मुसलमानों को दीन की हकीकत समझाई है. दीन के बेशुमार वो पहलू जिनसे मुतल्लक बाज़ बहसें उठ खड़ी हुई थीं उनकी तनकीह की है. बाज़ ऐसी ताबीरात की गलती बाज़े की है कि जो अगर वो न करते तो शायद बड़े हवादिस मुसलमानों के साथ होते. मुसलमानों को इस दुनिया में जीने के लिए क्या रवैया इख्तियार करना चाहिए उनके लिटरेचर ने बताया है, और अल्लाह ताला के साथ ताल्लुक का कैसे इंसान की ज़िंदगी में ज़हूर होना चाहिए इसके लिए बेहतरीन तहरीरें लिखी हैं. आप सब उनको पढ़ें, उनके लिटरेचर से इस्तेफादा करें. इस वक्त वो बिल्कुल आखिरी उम्र में पहुँचे हुए हैं. इस तरह के बुज़ुर्ग ज़मीन पर खुदा की बहुत बड़ी नेमत होते हैं.
अलबत्ता रिटन फॉर्म में इस उम्मत में मैं समझता हूँ कि इतने बड़े लेवल का काम किसी और शख्स ने नहीं किया पूरे 1400 साल के अंदर. दौरे हाजिर में इंडिया के एक बहुत बड़े स्कॉलर हैं मौलाना वहीदुद्दीन खान. उनकी उम्र इस वक्त 95 इयर्स है. आप गूगल में जाके मौलाना वहीदुद्दीन खान लिखें तो विकिपीडिया पे उनका तारुफ भी खुल जाएगा और इंशाल्लाह हम अपने थंबनेल पे भी उनकी तस्वीर लगाएंगे. अपने साथ मैं उनकी तस्वीर लगाऊंगा इंशाल्लाह ताला. उनकी वेबसाइट आप देख सकते हैं cpsglobal.org, सेंटर फॉर पीस एंड स्पिरिचुअलिटी cpsglobal.org उनकी वेबसाइट है. उस पर उनकी सैकड़ों किताबें रखी हुई हैं और मैं बहुत बड़ा दावा कर रहा हूं पूरी इस्लामिक हिस्ट्री में 1400 साल के अंदर किसी शख्स ने इतना बड़ा काम इस हवाले से नहीं किया.
Now I want all Muslims to focus on what Maulana Wahiduddin Khan Sahib has written. It is an eye-opener for all Muslims and can really help them. Many Muslims now have this same view but hide it out of fear of persecution. But I really appreciate that Maulana Sahib did not fear anyone and spoke the truth. The name of his book is Qiyamat Ka Alarm, meaning the alarm for the day of judgment. Let us start from page 49 of this book, which he titles The Issue of the Second Coming of the Messiah. On this page he beautifully explains a few things. He says that many believe that Hazrat Isa alayhisalam is alive in the heaven and will return bodily in the end times. This view is spread but is not proven from the Quran or the Ahadith. Many narrations speak of a Messiah coming. However, no narration says that Hazrat Isa alayhisalam is alive in the heavens. His descent from the heavens physically is also not present in the Ahadith. The only true point is that the narrations use the words Ba'atha and Nazul, but these words do not prove that Hazrat Isa alayhisalam is alive in the heaven. The word Nazala in Arabic just refers to a person coming rather than coming from the heaven. A guest is called a Nazil, meaning one who comes. Ba'atha also does not refer to someone descending from the heavens. It just means getting up or appearing. Both words have nothing to do with someone coming down from the heavens. Hazrat Ahmad al-Islam has explained these very same points over 100 years ago throughout his books. On page 50 he explains that these prophecies refer to a person who would play the role of the Messiah, meaning someone like Hazrat Isa alayhisalam of Bani Israel, rather than the same prophet of 2000 years ago who has died, according to the Quran and the Hadith. He says that the reality is that it refers to someone in the end times from the Muslim Ummah who would perform these tasks mentioned in the prophecies. He then says that the killing of Dajjal is not a physical killing, rather with arguments. The same was said by Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the promised Messiah. He then says that this is not strange. The Ummah has always had scholars who have said this. He refutes all Muslims here who claim that there is some sort of ijma, meaning consensus, that Hazrat Isa alayhisalam is alive in the heaven. He then names scholars who agree, including Mufti Muhammad Abdu, Sheikh Muhammad Shaltut, Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, Abul Kalam Azad, and then also quotes Hazrat Ibn Taymiyyah that he said, the concept of Isa alayhisalam being alive in the heavens is a disputed matter, meaning there is no ijma or consensus on this. He also explains that no one will descend from the heavens. On page 45, he quotes the hadith that there is no Mahdi except the Messiah of the end times, and explains that the Imam Mahdi and the Latter-day Messiah are in fact one person, once again supporting the view of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the promised Messiah alayhi salam. Then on page 56, he explains that the Messiah would not descend physically from the heavens, which is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that when you see him, recognize him. He then explains that the ending of other religions means that the Messiah would end them through heavenly signs. Once again, exactly what the promised Messiah alayhi salam explained. Maulana Wahiduddin Khan Sahib has joined the company of thousands of other Muslim scholars who have accepted the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, fulfilling a great prophecy of the promised Messiah. In the end, I pray that other Muslims benefit from the words of Wahiduddin Khan Sahib and accept the true Islam, which is Ahmadiyyat. Ameen. Make sure to follow the Ahmadi Answers Instagram page for tabligh posts. Many have made accounts just to follow this page to stay updated, since it is hard to make regular YouTube videos. May Allah guide all Muslims to the true teachings of Islam. Ameen.
صلي على محمد صلي على سفينا صلي على محمد صلي على